Trying to remember, we have a payment coming in year five. The contract was it five, year five? You remember?
Yeah, there should be a, yeah, the second payment. I'd have to look at the contract to see what it was, but the like lump sum, you should have another one.
So, I guess we should probably put that in the minutes of the next meeting, just where we are, that final number. We don't have to put the whole thing in there. Okay? Thank you.
You're welcome.
Current programming effort, anything else about funds before we move on?
No.
What are we doing on our programming efforts?
We are covering local events, and we are continuing to cover planning board and board of selectmen meetings and public hearings. So if the conservation commission has a public hearing or ZBA has a public hearing, we cover those. Yeah, and then we've been covering local events.
Us.
And yes, I am sorry. We are also recording cable advisory committee meetings.
Next month is a meeting, and the state's going to present plans for the downtown area.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I did see that.
Cover that.
Yeah, I did see a post about that and was planning to cover it.
I think there'd be quite a bit of interest.
Yeah, it was the center.
Where's that going to be?
Town Center Committee.
Here?
I think so. I don't know.
Yeah, I'd have to look, but it's like the Town Center Committee.
Yeah.
Yeah. We had covered when they had done a presentation previously, they did it over at the elementary school, and we had covered that.
Yeah, it'd be, that would be of great interest, I would think, to people in town. And I have good news about viewership. I have a group of gentlemen. We don't like to call ourselves elderly, we are, who meet, and I'm the only one who actually is excited about getting online and taking a look at what's going on in town. And in the last 6 months, they're all online now.
Wow.
They're all watching, and so much so that a couple of them have even come to meetings. I think they were at the planning board meeting when they were talking about the marijuana thing, and they got that information.
They stopped watching before they started smoking marijuana.
No, I'm it's the conversation you guys don't need here, but
good.
It was because these are Paul Wormy and those guys. I mean, hard case. You know, two of them don't even have
TVs.
Well, they got TVs, but they don't have, you can't, they don't have an email address. You can't, it's hard to get a hold of them. So we're breaking down barriers, small as they might be. I did talk to, Gary flagged me down somewhere, and he's got some, couple of things he's getting ready to come back to.
Okay.
Have you been working with him recently?
Yeah, the last time that we tried to have a meeting, I went over to his house after the meeting and had assisted him with a few things, and we've been slowly kind of releasing different things that he has. He just has like a huge catalog, and I don't want to dump it. I don't want to dump it all online at the same time.
I won't be here. I won't be alive. Yes.
Right, no, he keeps talking about new projects, and I'm like, wait, I haven't finished with the others.
Yeah,
but yeah, we have quite a few of his stuff.
Yeah, great. Okay, how are we for needs for additional hardware, software? Do we have anything that we know is coming up, or are we in pretty good shape?
Software, we are fine. Hardware, video switcher is starting to show some signs of wear. One of the monitors, there's a line across it and it's been getting bigger, so that may need to be replaced. Hopefully it's just a part that can be replaced rather than the entire thing. And then the remote control for the cameras, it's not holding the recorded positions any longer, so that may be on its way out as well. The remote control for the cameras, actually, when we had talked about outfitting this room with microphones to improve the sound and stuff like that, I had asked the installer to include a replacement camera controller in the quote.
Well, it probably works. It probably just needs a cartridge or something.
At our next meeting, could we get a, could you
we
give us some kind of a, an estimate of what you recognize that we do? Oh, you got it.
Yeah, we have it.
This doesn't include the video switcher monitor, but that is still functioning normally right now, so we don't need to replace it yet, but just to keep you informed, it's showing some signs.
So we're looking at a total of somewhere around $1,800.
Yeah, so this includes a replacement camera controller. So the one that we have is a Sony one, which is the same brand as these camera controllers. But a replacement Sony one is about $2,000, and this company just came out with a compatible controller that does the same thing for a little over $300. So I thought that would be a little bit better use of funds.
So that's new equipment?
That is brand new equipment, correct.
Okay, and how about the layer mics?
Yep, so those microphones are additional microphones, which we talked about installing additional microphones in here to get better sound,
right,
especially from the audience.
And the third?
That's
estimate, new equipment?
The third thing on the line, that's labor.
Oh, installation, I apologize.
No worries.
Thank you. Okay, gotcha.
So this is the same installer that did our setup here previously.
Okay. Is there any questions and comments about that?
Is this a spot to make a motion that we purchase these? And
are we going to have discussion first?
Huh?
Are we going to have discussion first?
No.
Well, you can't do that.
Got to make
the
motion first. Yeah. But I'm just wondering.
I thought the motion was made for a vote, not for discussion.
Are you the parliamentarian for this
No,
group?
No, I'm asking.
No, you need it. You need a motion and a second,
right, and
then you discuss.
My question was, is this an appropriate place to make a motion to accept the quote?
Okay.
And purchase the equipment.
Do you want to second it, or I will?
You can.
I'll second it. Now, discussion.
Quite personally surprised by the email we got for the inquiry regarding the as best I could determine from the state's attorney general about funding for the door and how that came out of our money. Could barely remember the incident even taking place.
I've spent 20 hours on the phone with him.
Well, maybe we should be hearing from you then regarding that matter. Because I'm leery of, what I'm getting at is, I'm leery of spending any permanent money for this room from our budget as a result of, for example, the door. And the state's attorney general coming back and looking at us as she is entitled to.
Yeah.
Right? It's one thing if we have portable equipment that we categorize and move from place to place, et cetera. It's another thing to say that we're using our money to retrofit certain elements.
Well, I had a long conversation with her. We pulled out the minutes of the meetings to help me a little bit too. First off, the issue that they think they're looking at, and I mean has to do with a another expenditure, not one of ours, that occurred in this about the same timeframe. My sense is that they're looking at, based on the questions I was being asked, that the issue was who made the bids, and how did we pick the bidder, in this case we had one one of the three had a recommendation of being really good, had done work around here before, and it happened to also be the least expensive. My sense is that they were just, I think they were looking at, you know, that there was an inside track for somebody to get that, to do the door. Because she never said anything about this. I tried to ask that question.
Yeah, okay, fair.
So we, you know, and she kept coming back. I mean, this was several days in a row, and she kept coming back to, you know, who made the bid, who suggested this person, how did you decide to do this? And, I explained to her that it was a contractor who had been doing work around here and had a good reputation, and it was easily the low cost bid. Now, there was the issue of why did you fix a door to the police station, and I explained to her that we had an access problem. The access problem, the police had that door that came out of this room and going into the police station, was locked on that side. So in order for us to get in there, we had to get the police, somebody in there to open it for us. And that, as you know, we have all of our equipment back there, and if we had an evening meeting and the guy was off somewhere, you had no way of getting in there. So the door needed some repair, and we decided to, because we needed that access, that's how we decided to do that. She was happy with that. That was fine. She was great. That was good information. I'm not the only person that was on the phone. He's been on the phone for way, way more hours than I have been. And she personally told me when she was done that this had nothing to do with us.
We were the only board that got singled out. How could she say that? The email went out to us, members of this particular board. She didn't cast the net broadly enough to go.
Well, I don't know that you know that.
Zoning Board of Appeals, Board of Selectmen, Conservation Commission, etc.
I think she probably went out to people who spent money to have something done. It's not a threatening thing. She's doing her job.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. And there's nothing for us to worry about. No, there's not. There is if we do something stupid. I mean, if we say,
we,
hey, I got a brother-in-law.
Yeah.
But I think that's what she was looking for. And I've had two people, one in-house and her, she's just looking at, she's got, it's obviously there's somebody in town who has filed a complaint. Somebody has filed a complaint, and so they're looking into it. And it isn't a complaint. The only reason we're involved in this was we're somebody that had a project in that time frame, and I don't know what that time frame is. That's she doesn't give me any, and she shouldn't be giving me any information other than she personally assured me that this wasn't, they weren't looking specifically at anybody here. They were just looking at the process.
Al, I know that that has probably affected your voting for spending money, but it, the money we're asking, we're being asked to spend enhances or replaces equipment that gets our mission out, which is broadcasting the meetings and making sure people can hear what's going on. I personally have tried, I can't hear anybody that's back here for some reason or other, you know? I mean, anything at the table is pretty loud and clear, but it's, you're hearing people answer questions, you don't know that what the question is because you can't hear it. Not a good thing.
No, I get feedback about the lack of ability to hear.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, that's a limitation.
Does that answer your question?
That's a limitation of the setup right now.
Any other discussion on this? All in favor? Opposed? 2-1? Motion passes.
One question I guess I'd have. These state vendors, you know, they're on the vendor list.
Well, this, yes, they are on the vendor list, but this is well below the threshold, so it doesn't.
Okay, yeah.
Need to, we don't need to worry about that.
That was another question too, was the $10,000 threshold. And, you know, the question was, well, who told you that? And I said, several people told us that. I mean, you know, I've known that for years. So we were nowhere near that. So. Okay, so that takes us, is there any other new business that needs to come before us? Hearing none, old business. Does this also, this discussion we just had, is that our discussion of the additional microphone cost?
Yes.
Okay. And the need to update our boards and committee members. I'm not real sure I know what we're trying to do there.
On the cable, I think we were waiting for Lori's software.
Yeah, and I believe Lori has been updating it.
Update.
She had, yeah, we had communicated a couple weeks ago. She said she was updating the slides.
Okay.
That's all we're waiting for, so that it can be.
Yeah.
Updated.
Yeah, I had taken them off the air because they were,
so,
you know, incorrect or whatever, expired, and she was correcting them and putting them back on.
Okay. I ran into her. She was at the meat raffle Friday, and I talked to her for a few minutes. This didn't come up. Okay. Any other old business? Okay. Hearing none. We have minutes to approve from our last meeting of November 18th.
Pardon? You want me to make a motion to approve?
Yeah.
Make a motion, we approve the minutes of the October meeting.
Second.
November meeting.
November, I'm sorry.
Okay.
No,
personal email addresses, at least mine anyway, I don't know how you guys feel, I don't know how Gary feels or anyone else who's a member of this board, or affiliated with this board, no longer be provided to any third party individuals. Within house, okay, I know where it's coming from, I know where it's going, I know the need for us all to be aware of what's going on in the board, et cetera. Beyond that, it not be allowed without somebody reaching out to that person and getting either written or verbal approval.
I can say that I get a email that involves fraud at least once a day. There's all kinds of $1 million in funds waiting for me somewhere in Central Africa, you know, and other things. But I mean every single day. So I think somebody I may have put away at one point in time has gotten my email address and put it out there for spamming, you know?
Well, yeah, and I've
when we started, at least myself, I remember, when I started on this board, because for example, you and I, well, we all kind of three came from the same similar vibe. You were a state employee, you and I were on the federal end.
Right.
There was a clear distinction.
Absolutely.
And God help you if, like with the door, you cross that. And you said, well, I'm going to have my brother-in-law paint the ship, or I'm going to have my brother-in-law fix our cars. Right, okay, so you know, maybe you can appreciate where I'm coming from, or maybe that gives you a idea of where my mind is at regarding this matter. But you had your own personal email, you had your own personal email, and if they wanted to get to you through your work, they'd have to go through John Nason, whatever it was, Tom Collier, whatever it was, and Alfonso, wherever it was. Okay, because there was that clear distinction, private versus work, and you weren't going to use your public car, truck, boat, etc. for private business. We started here almost a decade ago. I was shocked to learn that under the original contract with Charter Spectrum, there was only three email addresses allotted to the town. I still am shocked to this day that nobody has held their feet to the fire and said, whether it's the town administrator, select board, anybody affiliated with any of the committees here in town, highway department, the chief of police, etc., that not everyone has been assigned a .hubbardston.gov email address. So, like I said, I don't see here, I can reach out to you, you can reach out to me, I know where you live, you know where I live.
Right.
We can communicate directly, meet me here, John, likewise, see him over there on occasion, he can approach me, I can approach you, etc. But unless they're going to provide what customary, what's grown to be a customary business email address, I'm not asking for anything exceptional. I'm not trying to be cutting edge. I'm not trying to you know, do something that nobody's ever done before.
No, actually, I agree with you.
I don't think it should be
put out. I'll approach our town administrator to with the overall concept, but I'll request that we have one for the chairman of this committee, and that when people are looking to talk to this committee by email, then that's the one they would use. And if somebody asks for an email address, it would be the chairman's. And I think that's probably should be for every chair or every committee we have in the. Yeah, you make a really good point.
Mm-hmm.
I'll do that. I'll approach him and I'll report back at our next meeting. So I need to update her about what we just decided to do. I'll do that as soon as she gets back. Anything else to come up?
Good.
I'm good. All right. And, And I was probably a few minutes late, 'cause I noticed when I pulled out of the driveway, it